Marta Argerich and Daniel Barenboim played Schubert's Rondo in A major. And what a wonderful celebration of a profound and enduring musical friendship. Well, 3 years ago, Daniel Barenboim conducted Wagner's complete Ring Cycle here at the Proms with the Staatskapelle Berlin. Tonight, with the West Eastern Divan Orchestra, he's back with more Wagner, conducting music from three of the composer's operas, the overtures to Tannhäuser and the Master Singers of Nuremberg, and excerpts from Götterdämmerung, Twilight of the Gods. In fact, the history of this great composer's music here might surprise you, especially if you think you know which composer has been the biggest presence at the Proms. Well, over the festival's 122-year history, it may actually not be who you'd expect.
I would guess Beethoven.
Elgar.
Tchaikovsky.
I'd have to say Beethoven.
Because with one man having almost twice as many performances of his works as his closest rival, he clearly takes the crown. Or should that be the ring? Wagner was given pride of place in the Proms calendar from some of founder conductor Sir Henry Wood's earliest Proms performances. For decades, Wagner Mondays had the composer as a pillar of the Promming programme. By 1914, bolstered by a fashion for abridged concert versions of larger works, Wagner had amassed almost 2,500 Proms performances of his works. The onset of the First World War brought a public dislike of all things German, Wagner included. But it was Hitler's championing of the composer as a chronicler of pure German identity that has, since 1945, made his works irrevocably controversial, especially for Jewish musicians. The Monday Wagner nights were abandoned. But it wasn't long before he had the Prommers queuing to see his works more regularly. Gradually, Wagner's position amongst the pantheon of composer giants at the Proms has once again grown. In 2013, Daniel Barenboim conducted the Ring Cycle over four evenings at the Proms, quite a departure from those abridged concert versions over a century previously. Barenboim returns tonight with a reprise of Wagner, proving that with this composer, the old sorcerer will continue to conjure up the crowds. The music of Wagner at the Proms, and tonight we'll be adding to that great history. Here comes Daniel Barenboim to conduct the West Eastern Divan Orchestra in the overture to Tannhäuser. Then Dawn and Siegfried's Rhine Journey and Siegfried's Funeral March from Götterdämmerung, Twilight of the Gods, and finally the overture to the Master Singers of Nuremberg. Wagner's Overture to Tannhäuser, performed by the West Eastern Divan Orchestra, conducted by Daniel Kleinberg. And next, Dawn and Siegfried's Rhine Journey and Siegfried's Funeral March from Götterdämmerung, Twilight of the Gods.
Thank you.
Daniel Barenboim, acknowledging the horn player Merv Goldman there, who played the sound of Siegfried, the hero's call.
Siegfried's Funeral March. And before that, we had heard Dawn and Siegfried's Rhyme Journey, both from Wagner's Götterdämmerung, The Twilight of the Gods, a final instalment of Wagner's Ring Cycle. Going to continue with an extract from Wagner. Next, the overture to the Master Singers of Nuremberg.
Thank you.
the overture to the master singers of Nuremberg, crowning that powerful selection of music from Wagner's operas, performed by the West Eastern Divan Orchestra, conducted by Daniel Barenboim, who was conducting entirely from memory. You may have noticed no music score in front of him. Wagner himself sanctioned the performance of selected highlights from his operas. In the case of The Ring in particular, he offered a chance to introduce the works to the public when fully staged performances weren't possible. Barenboim is one of the world's leading interpreters of Wagner's music. He first conducted in Bayreuth in 1981 and returned there every summer for 18 years. And Daniel Barenboim is returning to the stage. Encouraging his young musicians to take another bow.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. From this wonderful applause that warms our hearts, I can tell you know the Meistersinger at least very well, the overture. So, we are not going to play the rest of the first act. We're also not going to play the second act, but we'll go directly to the prelude to the third act. Thank you.
the prelude to Act 3 of the Master Singers of Nuremberg. Performed there as an encore, Daniel Barenboim conducting the musicians of his West Eastern Divine Orchestra. Tonight's prom is part of the orchestra's four-city, six-concert tour across Europe. Earlier this month, they were at the Salzburg Festival, the Waldbühne in Berlin, and at the Lucerne Festival. They'll finish at the Teatro della Maestranza in Seville. Well, the audience still won't let Daniel Barenboim go. And he is coming back on stage now. I think we can expect a little more Wagner, perhaps. Jubilant finish to this evening's prom, the prelude to Act 3 of Lohengrin. Lohengrin was first performed in 1850 with Franz Liszt conducting. He was a close friend and early supporter of Wagner. which makes an interesting link this evening to that spellbinding performance of Liszt's first piano concerto we heard Marta Argerich play earlier. Well, that is it for tonight, but make sure you tune in to BBC4 again on Friday when Sir Simon Rattle and the Berlin Philharmonic will be performing Mahler's Seventh Symphony and Pierre Boulez's Éclat. But for now, from me, Samira Ahmed, from Daniel Barenboim and the West Eastern Divan Orchestra, and all of us at the Royal Albert Hall, good night.